Welcome to AZ Solutions Auto Calculate Tables. What I'll be showing you is the various different methods that we can introduce tables into our PowerPoint presentations. Firstly, I will show you how we can insert a table using the option from here. The other method will be how we can copy and paste a table, draw a table from scratch. And the last option is bring in a table from or create a table within PowerPoint so that you can retain all the mathematical calculations as opposed to copying it from Excel and then pasting it here. So let's begin. So inserting a table. When you choose your layout, you'll choose the layout that says title and content. And as you hover through the center, you'll find the various different items that you have available to you. And we're going to use the one for insert table. It will ask you the number of columns and rows. We can change that at any time, and we'll make that just three columns and two rows. And then you have your table ready to start creating. Simply type what you would like in the headings. And that's how we can get going with a table using the insert table technique. You will be given the table design and layout tab at the top. You'll notice they're in a different color to the others. See, these are black, whereas this one is red in color to stand out. Just notice that if you click outside of the table area, you will no longer have that feature available. Click inside the table area, and then you will have the ribbon to continue to play with your table. If you choose the layout tab, the ribbon will change so that you can play with all of these features. Let's take a look at the next method for inserting a table into PowerPoint. And this is the copy and paste. Now, most of you would be saying, sure, you just go there, you say Control C to copy, come in here, Control V to paste, and that's it. Sure, you can do it that way. Or, yes, you will come in here and say copy. You can do the Control C or right mouse click to copy. When you come back to PowerPoint, you will right mouse click instead. And that way, you will get various options. You will get the option to paste it in here, but allow it to meet the theme colors that is here in PowerPoint as opposed to what you had in Excel. You may want to do the opposite, and for whatever reason, you may want to keep the coloring that was in the Excel. Now, when you bring it into here, sometimes the image, when you straight out copy and paste using either of those two techniques, it may distort or not stay intact very well. So what you might like to try and do is bring it in as a picture. Now, when you bring it in as a picture, the only downfall there is that you won't be able to do animation to animate each column to come in separately. You can choose to do a link where you keep the coloring from the previous, or bring it in as a link and also keep the destination, the formatting to match the destination that we have here. Now, when we do this link, it means that if it updates and changes in Excel, it will update and change in here. You can always resize it. That's to bring in your graph. We can bring in a table that we draw ourselves. Maybe the standard columns and rows are not what we're after, and we find ourselves constantly merging. In this instance, we can go to Insert, Table, choose the Draw Table option. You will get a pencil icon. You will click and drag diagonally to draw the outer frame that you want to start with. You will again that get the table design and layout tab appearing up the top. And what we now need to do is keep the pencil active for the draw table. Don't be tempted to touch the edge. Click away from it, hold the mouse button down, and as you're dragging, once you get just a little under halfway across, it will draw the line the rest of the way. See how I'm way away from the edge? So you can draw lines in any direction you might like. Now, if we've made a mistake and you want to get rid of that line, you use the eraser and that will remove that particular line. The last method, we may need to insert a table. However, I don't want to be spending time typing in the calculations myself. So I will insert this time. Instead of drawing a regular table as you might, or insert table or draw as we've done before, we will use an Excel spreadsheet. When you do the Excel spreadsheet, you will notice that your ribbon is a different color. It is green. It's green because we're actually in Excel. You'll notice that we have a tab here for formulas, which you don't have if you that you don't have when you're in PowerPoint. So we are in fact in Excel, meaning we can do everything that we normally would do when we are in Excel. Seems to be having a little glitch, I think. There we go. So I'm going to type in January, February, just as I would if I was in Excel, being able to fill it across. And fill in the amounts. Now you may want to enlarge this, and when you click out of it, if you come out of it and then grab the corner, it will enlarge the whole item. Notice I have some extra spacing in between here. If I double click, I will get back into Excel and I can reduce the size, click away, and then it's gotten rid of those extra grid lines. If I need to change any of those figures, I will double click and actually change the figure. I can add another sheet where I do some calculations. I'm simply going to do a multiply, just as I would when I'm in Excel, because I am still actually, in fact, in Excel. Click away from it, and I now have my calculation in there. If at any time the price changes or the quantity changes, simply double click, which will get you to the Excel mode. Make your change. Your item is automatically updated, and there it reflects the change. Thank you for watching AZ Solutions. Remember to subscribe to my channel.